Google Calendar is my absolute favorite tool to help keep my family organized. I have several different calendars, and there's so much you can do with Google Calendar, so I thought I'd break down some of my best tips on Google Calendar to help your family stay on the same page and super organized. Now, one of the great things about Google Calendar is that you can create so many different calendars. I have a whole video on all the different calendars that I use with Google Calendar that includes a different calendar for every family member. It also includes a meal planning calendar, bill paying calendar, workout calendar, school calendar. There's so many calendars that you can add to help keep your family color coordinated and organized. But this video is going to concentrate on some of the things you can do just within Google Calendar itself to help keep your family on the same page. One of the main things you can do with Google Calendar is to track your tasks. It does integrate with Google Tasks, and these tasks can be shown directly on the calendar itself. So you can be going about your day, looking at your calendar, and checking off the items on your to-do list all within the same interface. So this also means that any tasks that you add with your voice, if you're going to be talking to a Google Nest device, will also be added directly to your calendar. Hey Google, remind me to record YouTube video.
Okay, record YouTube video. When do you want to be reminded?
4:50 p.m. today.
Okay, at 4:50 p.m. Also, if you have an iPhone, you'll need to download Google Tasks or Google Calendar to get the notification.
The Google Nest devices will remind you of that task, and you can check it off within the Google Nest. Or, since it's showing up on the Google Calendar, you can just check it off right there as well. This helps you from not having to jump from task list to calendar and back and forth. You can just see everything right there in the same interface. Another setting that is often overlooked is a default reminder for any appointment on any of your specific calendars. So if you want to set a reminder for a half an hour or 10 minutes before any appointment comes up without having to set that within the appointment itself, you can set a default right here in the settings of that particular calendar. It's going to send you a notification when you have set for that notification to go off. You can add additional notifications if you're the kind of person who needs to be reminded a half an hour before something starts and 5 minutes before something starts. I can admit I'm guilty of that sometimes. So this default reminder setting will be really helpful for people who may forget about appointments that are happening later in the day. You can also set a default reminder for any all-day appointments. So if you have an all-day appointment that you want to be reminded of the day before, you can set that as a default right here in the settings of your calendar. I did mention that I have a lot of calendars that I've added, but there's a really easy way to add all of the holidays that are important to your area. So for us, it is the United States. I can come into the settings of the Google Calendar and add an additional calendar, and you can browse through specific calendars that you might want to add. Most of these are holidays, but you can add the moon phases and birthdays for any contacts that you have. So I also really like to do that. If I have a contact and I put their birthday in the contact, it will automatically show up if I have this birthday calendar checkmarked. This helps you keep up with birthdays instead of trying to add an appointment for your friend's birthday, your friend, family member birthday. Just add the birthday into the contact, and then it can port over automatically without creating all of those additional appointments. Another thing that's often overlooked is adding the location of your appointment. I love to put in the exact address of the appointment location because you can get alerts that it's time to leave for that appointment based on your current location. It says, oh, hey, you're at home and this appointment is a half an hour away. You should probably leave now. So if you're adding the location for your appointment, you can get these alerts saying, hey, it's time to go. which I really like. The other thing is when I'm looking for that appointment or if I'm heading to that appointment, I can tap on the calendar appointment and then tap find on map. And this is going to open up my Google Maps and I can navigate directly to that appointment. I don't have to search for the address or anything. If I just add the address to the appointment itself, all of that is really integrated and I can get to my appointment on time. Along with that is another overlooked fact that you can attach files to appointments. So if you have paperwork or tickets that have a QR code, you can attach those images to your appointment so that you have that readily available and you don't have to search for your phone for that QR code or search for that file that you needed for the appointment. It can all be attached right to the appointment itself, and then you can have that information readily available when it is required during the appointment or during the event. If you're looking at your Gmail on the web, you can have the calendar right here on the right. And as you do that, if you're looking at a particular email that needs to be scheduled for an appointment, you can add the appointment and it will add details from the email because you're already looking at that email. It's going to just grab that information and put it into the calendar appointment. So it's really integrated and really easy to make appointments and even make tasks directly from your email messages. And finally, this is one of the questions that I get asked the most from my other video is what to do when you have multiple family members and you want to schedule an appointment for all the family members. Because my recommendation is that every family member have their own calendar. And so if I put something on my calendar, I would have to repeat that appointment for my daughter's calendar, my son's calendar, my husband's calendar, etc., etc. So what is the solution? Instead of having four different appointments that all occur at the same time, what's the solution? My recommendation is to create an additional calendar that is just for the family. So any family appointments would go on this calendar. Now make sure you share this calendar with every member of the family. You can take a look at my other video on how to exactly do that sharing. But if you share this family calendar, so for us, we would call it maybe Kimmel Family, and then any appointments that everybody needs to attend, I can put on this Kimmel Family calendar. Now everybody has access to it. It shows up on all of their devices. And since it's a specific color or it's the Kimmel family appointment, they know it is for everybody. So that's really helpful instead of having multiple appointments for every member of the family. Now when only one or two people need to be at a specific appointment, you will probably have to duplicate those appointments. So it's on my calendar and my daughter's calendar or something like that. But for anything that is for the entire family, I just recommend an additional calendar that is specific for the entire family. So those are the Google Calendar tips and hacks for your family. Hopefully that helped you out a little bit, get you all organized and on the same page and running your house a little bit smoother. Make sure you subscribe to this channel, hit that notification bell. Let me know in the comments if you enjoy this content so I can make sure to include more productivity content for your family on this channel. When you like and comment on the video, that helps me understand that that is something you're interested in. So go ahead and follow me on social media. I'm Family Tech on all platforms, and we will see you next time.